आज हम पढ़ेंगे ग्राफिकल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ मोशन, डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ मोशंस. लेट मी फर्स्ट टेल यू द मोशन इज टू टाइप्स, यूनिफॉर्म मोशन एंड द सेकेंड टाइप इज नॉन यूनिफॉर्म motion. What is uniform motion? Uniform motion is equal distance is covered by the object in equal interval of time. Equal interval of time. This is called uniform motion. And your non-uniform motion is that equal distances are not covered in equal time. So in a given time, the distance covered are different in non-uniform motion. Distance covered different in a time interval, in time intervals. So in uniform motion, what happens? Velocity is constant. And in the non-uniform motion, velocity is not constant. Now let us now discuss the graphical representation of uniform motion. We see there is one is XT graph. This is represent change in position of the object with respect to time. We are taking first uniform motion. In uniform motion, the change in position with respect to time, the object covers equal distance. So the graph is like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in equal time, equal interval of time, the distance covered is also equal. If we represent it by a VT graph, here in place of position or distance, we take velocity of the object, VT graph. In case of VT graph, in uniform motion, the VT graph velocity is constant. Here it is V, here it is T. Velocity is constant. So we say that if in velocity is here, then it will remain constant with respect to time. This is VT graph of uniform motion. Now we take non-uniform motion. Here XT graph or distance time graph will be like this, or it may be like this. Here you see that in fixed interval of time, the distance covered are different. Here also the distance covered are different. So this is example of non-uniform motion. Now if we, this is XT graph. Now we take velocity time graph of non-uniform motion. In velocity time graph, time is taken along x-axis and along y-axis, we take velocity. So this type of graph is velocity is changing but at an equal rate with respect to time. This is also an example of non-uniform motion. In case of VT graph, velocity is changing at an equal rate. This is a non-uniform motion where V is along y-axis, velocity is along y-axis and time is along x-axis. In this case, velocity is changing at an equal rate. So there another concept comes, acceleration. Acceleration is rate of change of velocity. This we will study further in our next topic. And coming back to velocity time graph of non-uniform motion, this time velocity, this is also non-uniform motion. Velocity time, this is also non-uniform motion. So non-uniform are represented by XT graph and VT graph. And we have studied that in case of uniform motion, we had studied that the XT graph is like this, and VT graph is this. This is uniform motion. Velocity is constant. And in non-uniform motion, velocity is not constant. The XT graph will be like this. In a regular time interval, the distance covered are different. And this is also non-uniform motion in which velocity is changing at an equal rate. So the graph will come a straight line. Now we take example of acceleration. What is acceleration? Acceleration is rate of change of velocity या change of velocity with respect to time. This is represented by A. As we have studied, velocity is a vector quantity velocity is a vector quantity. Hence, rate of change of velocity, acceleration, is also a vector quantity. Vector quantity is one in which direction is also taken into consideration along with magnitude. So, A is equal to change of velocity. Change of velocity, let V is the final velocity and U is the initial velocity. Then change in velocity will be V minus U and time is T. So, we get A is equal to V minus U divided by T, or AT is equal to V minus U. V minus U is equal to AT. V is equal to U plus AT. This is the first equation of motion. This is the first equation of motion. We have got this equation by the definition of acceleration only. Now we take, this is our first equation, V is equal to U plus AT. Our second equation is regarding distance. S is equal to UT plus half AT square. How to prove it mathematically? To prove it mathematically, what we do, distance, this is distance. What is distance? Distance is the speed or velocity into time. S is, if velocity is changing, then we say average velocity, V average, or mean velocity into time. So, mean velocity is U plus V divided by 2. Into time. S is equal to average velocity into time, or mean velocity into time. Now V is equal to U plus AT. U plus AT divided by 2 into time t. U plus U, 2U by 2 plus AT into time, which is 2UT by 2 plus AT square divided by 2. Again, if we take 2 LCM, it will become this. S is equal to 2UT plus AT square divided by 2. It becomes 2UT divided by 2 plus half AT square. S is equal to 2 se 2 gaya. S is equal to UT plus half AT square. This is our second equation. See, average velocity u plus v by 2. Distance is equal to velocity into time. Average velocity into time. This, here we have taken value of v as u plus at from the first equation. U plus at. And then by solving it, we get 2ut plus at square divided by 2. And by again simplifying it, we get this equation. Now there is third equation, that is v square minus u square is equal to 2s, as. Mathematically, it is very simple to prove this equation. Let me write all the equations first. V is equal to u plus at. Second is s is equal to ut plus half at square. And third equation, we are going to prove it just now. V square minus u square is equal to 2as. Now, how to prove this equation? We consider second equation. And in second equation, we place the value of t derived from the equation 1. T is equal to v minus u divided by a. Putting this value of t in this second equation, what we get? Let us see. We get s is equal to u v minus u divided by a plus half a v minus u divided by a whole square. Putting the value of t in this equation, we get this. Now here we have v minus u divided by a, here we have v minus u divided by a. We take it as common, and inside the bracket we have got u plus half a. This is square, then when one factor comes here, the other factor remains here, v minus u divided by a. Okay friends, now it is, let us simplify it. Here a is cancelled with this a, denominator and numerator a cancels each other. It becomes v minus u divided by a u plus v minus u divided by 2. LCM 2 u plus v minus u, v minus u divided by a. Now 2 u minus u, it is u, and here it is v, so then it becomes v plus u, v minus u by a, v plus u by 2. This is equal to s is the distance. So we have formula a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. So v minus u multiplied by v plus u, it comes v square minus u square, and here 2a, it is equal to s. 2a comes here, 2as is equal to v square minus u square, and it can be written as also v minus u square, v square minus u square is equal to 2as. This is the third equation. So we have proved all the three equations mathematically. with the help of the equations itself and with the help of definition of acceleration. First equation is proved with the help of definition of acceleration, and the other two are proved with the help of equations. Now we can prove it graphically also. In our next video, we shall prove these equations graphically and will take up some problems based on these equations. Thank you.